There once were some boys from Anoka, Ramsey who wanted to play baseball competitively. Triple A, double A, single A, who cares? Just give them a field and see how they fare. Find a leader, the commissioner said, so a stalking two moms went, approaching Coach Rassett after fall ball in his hoodie and soaking wet. There were hours of cell phone minutes logged, board meetings to attend, more texts than one could even count, and numerous emails sent. Then came March 27th, word that our boys would play, a moment of pure joy, the start of Anoka 11A. At last these boys were practicing, at batting cages and inside a gym, their first go-round with Rassett. Yeah, that's a cool story, Zim. The boys were far from perfect, still plenty for them to learn. Day by day he taught them mechanics, how to hit, to throw, and turn. And day by day he earned their respect, because this coach, he had a gift of teaching boys to see their worth even when they completely whiff. And so the boys became ladies, 11 players living the dream. Together they started winning games, 10 running several teams. The nicknames were ever-changing, not sure which one would last. Coach Ryan used them all the time. The season went so fast. There was Big Stick Nick and Broccoli, DJ and Double Deuce. Relax out there, we've got a job to do, and don't forget to play loose. There was Lumberjack and Twinkle Toes, Zim City and Morgan as Mo. Inside the white lines we hustle, gloves dirty and ready to go. There was Dilly Bar, Sime Dog, and Goldilocks. Yes, Drew, that last one is you. Here's a great Clips coupon, use it, have them take off a few. Coach Matthew, a man of many signs, standing proud along third base, forced to make quick decisions and causing hearts to race. Coach Eric, the silent partner, an iPad in his lap, a nice compliment to not-so-quiet Ryan. You want me to autograph that? There were tournaments in Chanhassen, Wayzata, and River Falls, rain that wouldn't go away, and those insane umpire calls. And let's not forget that crazy one who collapsed and pretended to die. Was it the hit in the chest that put him on edge, or the lightning in the sky? Then there were those West Side chanters, the boys who wouldn't shut up, and that South St. Paul team we had to play twice. Admittedly, they were tough. Woodbury Blue didn't like to lose, at least that seemed the case. Why else would that annoying dad want to punch Brad in the face? Nerve-wracking describes the Orono game. We were down early 9-1, but the boys worked hard and came back strong. We ended up winning by a run. Team bonding was a pleasure. Good times at the Super 8. Lots of swimming for the kids. We stayed up way too late. There were trips to DQ and Two Scoops. Ice cream enjoyed by all. We don't care if you're camera shy. Be quiet and go pose on that wall. There were wiffle ball parties and laser tag. Team movies inside Stefan's van. After game dinners at Willie McCoy's. A break for us hot and tired fans. We qualified for two state tourneys. The only Anoka team to place at Gopher State. And ended the season as league champs. Who could have guessed our fate? Oh wait, those moms who went a-stalking on that rainy fall ball day, they had something like this in mind when they told AR these boys need to play. Yes, we're sad that it's over, new friends and memories, but now it's time to celebrate how great it turned out to be. So lift those Pepsis high in the air, we told you so, is all we'll say. Three cheers for the team that almost wasn't, Anoka 11A.
Look at me, I can be Santa Fe. fundraiser. Learn the game, play it the right way.
One, two, three, team!
Everything.